My name is Yvan Lusso. I'm a software developer at OBO, and I more specifically work on AQL, which stands for Accelo Query Language, and also on M2Doc, which is the topic of this talk. Why should we generate documentation? The main reason for that is usually you have some non-technical people that need to be informed about technical issue. And the best way to do that is usually to produce Word document to give them the right information. And also in the modeling world, usually you want to always have the business model as a reference, and when you are using this model to generate the documentation, you always make sure that the documentation will be up to date according to what is inside your model. So we were many organizations to have the same problem, and we regroup together in order to make M2Doc. So there was the French Department of Defense, the CNAV, which is a retirement fund agency, and CS, which is an integrator, and OBO, we are a software editor. So our solution is M2Doc, which stands for Model to Documentation. And the basic principle is you have your business model as an input, a template document. So the template is itself a Word document. And then you feed that to M2Doc, and the dynamic part of the template are replaced by the element from the model, and you get your document as output. For instance, if you have a model of an airplane, you can generate the documentation for this airplane. And of course, you can apply different templates to obtain different documents as output on the same model or different model. In this approach, we see three different roles. So the first one is the templatist. So it's a new word, I would say. And his role is responsible for editing, creating, and debugging the template, the M2Doc template. And for creating those templates, he rely on the actual services that are provided by the metamodel expert, which is responsible for the metamodel itself, metamodel definition, and making services to use this metamodel. And is also responsible to package the different services. And the last role we find is the end user, which is responsible for editing the model itself, and running the template with M2Doc. And last point is he also is responsible for editing user doc, which are protected area of the document you can edit, and that won't be lost at the next generation. So these are just roles, and they can be performed by one person or several people according to the complexity of your organization. So writing templates is quite simple. We use Microsoft Word editor with docx file, and inside this document we rely on the fields which can be activated using Alt F9. And you can insert a new field by using Control F9. And I will show a bit more details on the syntax itself. So when I use this notation on the following slide, it's a field from Word. And so all the directive for templating with m2doc start with m and a colon. And then you have several possibilities. The first one is by doing a simple query using an AQL expression. So you see the m2doc prefix, the expression. So here we have a variable conf, which have an attribute name, and we will use that to generate the output, which is at the bottom. And you can notice that the yellow color here is not a syntactical coloration, it's just the style of the expression that we use to produce the output in the document. And yes, everything that is not in a field is a static content that will be generated as is. We have a basic construction like loops to iterate over a collection of objects. And here we combine the loop with a bullet list to have this output at the end. But we can also combine it with tables and generate tables this way. We have a conditional in order to switch between different parts of the document according to a condition. This construction you can use also else if with another condition and else. This is optional, but it can be useful. I mean, the else at least. a really important point, I think, a great feature in m2doc is the user doc statement, where everything that is generated inside this block will be protected against new generation. So you can change the content of the block, regenerate, and still have the manual change in your output document. And this allows incremental generation, which is a real feature, I think, for documentation. We have bookmark and links. So bookmark are basically like anchor in HTML. So you can define a bookmark with a specific ID, and then you can refer to this bookmark using a link. And when you are in the output document, you can use a control click to navigate from the link to the bookmark. And we also have another type of construction where you can define your own variables, here CNAME, and then reuse them inside the block, the let block. Sometime you will have to write some expression like that, which is basically true if the conference contain at least one track speaking about Sirius. So it can be a bit tedious to write. So that's when you want to use services. So services are simple Java method that you can call from the AQL expression. So yes, it's a pure Java method. It can help to facilitate writing and reading, understanding templates, and it can also be used to extend the behavior of m2doc. And one nice thing also, you can directly use them to insert images, tables, and preformatted text. just by returning certain given kind of object, given type of object. And very useful features when you are writing your templates is the validation, because we all make mistakes sometimes. And so the validation will help you to figure out what is the error you made and also where it is in the document, because the error message will be shown near the problematic parts of the template. We also have an integration with Sirius. Sirius is a tool to create modeling modelers for models. So we have a set of services that can help you to directly insert your diagram and tables that are coming from Sirius inside your document. So now I will start a little demo showing you how templates work. So yes, this is a simple template that is using as input a conference model where I modelize some of the talks of this conference, and we basically generate few things. So we will start with a static image that will be inserted as is in the output document. First of all, we will insert a table of contents that will be updated when opening the document with Word. On the next page, we will have a section about speakers, and for each speaker, we will go through all speakers, sort the speakers by their last name, and then just create a bullet list with the speaker name. We will next have a section about tracks, with a subsection with the track name for each track, and a table with the talks in this track. And here we have a cell with a comment, and it is a user doc. So I will show you later how we can modify that, and it will survive the next generation. And last, we'll insert a diagram from Sirius about the talks, but shown according to the room that takes place. So this is a Sirius diagram, and we'll insert this diagram on the last page. So there is another aspect on the template. We are using custom properties from Word document to specify the variables we will be using. So here we find the conf variable I was using in the template, and we basically say declare its type. So it's here it's a conference. And then we use the conference metamodel here. We declare the conference metamodel here in order to be able to use this type. And the last element is what configures the running of the generation. So here we have to bind the conf variable with its actual value. So this value comes from the model here. And since we want to also import a diagram from Sirius, we have to define the Sirius session. So now I will generate the document. So just right click and then Use generate documentation. Okay, so everything is okay. And here I have a new document that I will open with the system editor. Okay, so here we see that there is a field for the table of content. So I have to switch back to not showing the field in order to show the actual content of the table of content. So this was the first page. So then we have the list of speakers sorted by their last name. And then we have the tracks section with each table, a table for each track. And on the last page, we have the Sirius diagram, which is inserted. And now I will demonstrate the iteration on document generation. So I will go to other cool stuff. I think I should attend this talk. Okay. And here I will put some okay, so outside of the user documentation block, the text will be lost. So let's save this. And I will generate again. If I go to other cool stuff, so we lost this text, but this command is still here. So that's how you achieve incremental generation. Okay. So back to the slides. So the architecture of M2Doc is quite simple. We rely on Axelo Query Language, Apache Poi, which is a library that allows to manipulate open OOXML documents, and EMF for the model part. On top of that, we have the core of M2Doc, which is standalone. You can use it outside of Eclipse. We also have an integration for Maven if you plan to build your documentation on Maven. On top of it, we have an IDE integration inside Eclipse and some GUI. And we made an integration with Sirius. But the good part with extension point and extensible software, that in fact this integration can be also your own product if you produce images or tables inside your software or want to take them from some other sources, you can also create your own integration. So the project is open source. You can find the code on GitHub. It's active in active development. We just released the first version a few weeks ago. So it's the first maintained version, meaning we try to add to keep the code, don't break any API and so on. It's fully documented, so you can go to the m2doc.org website and read the documentation by yourself. And we are also, our next steps are still gathering feedback from users, because We could do a lot of things, but it's better to focus on features that are needed by users. And also, we want to work on the integration with Poi because we have some issue we want to overcome, and we will probably contribute to Poi, at least try to contribute to Poi at some point. So, if you have a few points to keep in mind, M2Doc allow you to generate a Word document from EMF models. It can include tables or diagrams from Sirius or even other products if you integrate them. And it's quite simple syntax to use. We have validation, which is really nice to help you debug your templates. And we support incremental generation. Thank you. If you have any questions. Yes. Sorry? So we no, it's only Word for the moment. I mean, I think we will focus on Word. I thought about maybe PowerPoint, for instance. For Excel, it's quite difficult because the document is not like a stream; it's more a table. And so for now, we are just focusing on the DocX document. Yes?
You mentioned like the EMF, as long as there's any model combined with EMF themselves, so we're talking about anything, for example, we are in our team, we're working with Xtext documentation related. So, for example, like everything that is core, so should be
able
to.
Yes. Yeah. And also, by using services, you can get data from something different from a model, but we focused on the model part because we have a lot of tools that already use EMF models. Okay, thank you.